Welcome to a new video. This is the first one of many to come. Movie recommendations for you. This is like the third day of lockdown part two. Maybe this lockdown you can spend it watching movies like I did the first one. The movies I'll be talking about today are movies that touch my soul. And you might be wondering, what does that bloody mean, Amy? A movie that is so good and so well made that you can't help to feel all warm and fuzzy. Basically, chef kisses, but in the form of a movie. So those are these movies, and I hope you enjoy. Let's start with the movies. First movie I'll be talking about, which touched my soul when I watched it back in January, I watched Perks of Being a Wallflower. This is like one of the more not unique movies that touch people's soul, but this movie was so good. I don't know what I'm doing with my hands. I feel like Cam from Modern Family. I remember seeing like it when I was younger, but I always just thought there was just another like high school cheesy movie, but this is not it. This is beautiful. And to be honest, I can't really remember some of it, but I remember the feeling I have, and that's mostly how I enjoy movies. Yeah, this movie definitely made me cry at the end, and I feel like this movie was a good representation of mental health. And even though it's not what I've been through, I can't relate, but I can relate with some of it. It was kind of widely known as a good representation, so that's quite nice to see that in movies where it's not all just like cheesy and actual realistic. The music was so good. I absolutely loved the score of this movie. Literally exposed me to Come On Eileen again, and I love that song. And I literally forgot about it until I watched this movie, and I was like, oh my god, this song is absolutely banging. I've since added that to my playlist. That's how much I was touched by this movie. I don't know, it's just like a really like heartfelt movie to me. And Emma Watson's in it, and the only bad thing I'll say about this movie is like her accent. She's British, if you don't know her. I'm British. And she plays the worst American accent. No hate to her, brilliant actor. Her accent was just not it. I think it just would have worked better if she was just British. This movie like actually like stuck with me for quite a long time afterwards. I just kept on like thinking about it. That's when you know it's like a good movie. So if you haven't seen it, it's on Netflix, I think. The second movie I will be talking about is The Truman Show. I feel like this movie was like it's pretty popular in the last like year, but this really made me think about reality and like what life is. Quite philosophical topics, and I quite like that. I like to think, and it's kind of aesthetic somehow, and that is always a bonus. I love aesthetic stuff, and it's from a 90s, so it's got a 90s aesthetic, and I am guilty of loving it, kind of, you know, the whole 90s romanticization. It's quite fun just to see the 90s in movies. And I feel like with this movie, the basic foundation of this movie is just so brilliant and so amazing that literally it can be quite a simple storyline. So yeah, Truman Show, great movie.
Touch my soul.
Yeah, that's all I'm gonna say. I just take my word for it. Go watch it. The next movie that touched my soul is Silver Lining Playbook. I watched this in July, and I feel like this movie was so good because of the actors. It's got Jennifer Lawrence, Bradley Cooper, and Robert De Niro, and they are just so good actors. I don't know how to describe it. It's just such a good movie. It's about like Jennifer and Bradley are like characters in this town, and it's about like their lives. It's kind of got like a theme of mental health issues with them. I think it's a good portrayal, and it's kind of just a good movie. Like, it's a very rounded movie, and it's a very simple storyline, which makes the movie like weirdly good because I'm Generation Z.
Wait a minute!
I'm literally in the middle of editing this video. I'm listening to myself say Generation Z like I'm American. I'm so influenced by American culture. It's crazy. And my attention span is 15 seconds long from TikToks, but this movie was like pretty long, but because of the filmmaking and the acting, it was like you're just looking onto these people's lives, and I quite like that. And I've never really seen a movie like that before watching it, so it was like I was just like opening a window and having a peek into their lives. Oh, I don't know, I'm really not good at describing movies. Felt quite like adult watching it because it's something like adults watch, I think, because it's not very childish, so I felt very like proper. The next movie is called Joy. This is on Netflix. This is on Netflix, and it's literally got Jennifer Lawrence and Bradley Cooper in as well. And it's kind of got the same sort of type of movie. Maybe it's from by the same director, because that would make so much sense. Because it gives off the same kind of vibe, but different kind of setting. By the end, I was really rooting for Jennifer Lawrence, her character. Really good acting, and if I won't say myself, I'm a drama GCSE student, so I know good acting because I'm terrible. I cannot act to save my life. Who knew professionals were so good at acting? I know how difficult it is to make a character three-dimensional. Professional actors are professional for a reason, and they're really good at it. quite like inspiring because it's all about this woman. She's like, she wants to do so much when she was younger. She's like the only responsible one in her family and she just wants to build something of her own. And it's all about her journey of being successful, an entrepreneur. Who doesn't like an inspiring story? I'm quite easy to be influenced by movies. It's very easy for me to feel attached to a character. That's why I love TV shows so much, because I get very emotionally invested. The fourth movie, which touched my soul, is Avengers Endgame. This is a literal piece of art. I am a new lover of super people. Superhuman, is that what they're called? Endgame was amazing. And I watched it in cinemas and it was the best experience of my life. I'm very grateful that I got to do that. Now with cinemas being shut, I miss it a lot. I watched his YouTube video about how they filmed it with the special effects, and bloody hell, the special effects people need more recognition because they literally make it. Like the actors, they're amazing. I know, great cast, but the special effects literally transform it to the Endgame. You know, it is very long of a movie, but I kind of like it because it was still very compelling and it's got different like parts of the movies which I like, so it's kind of split up in a very good way. And it is the end of Avengers franchise, so it very wholeheartedly rounds up all the movies. I watched all the Marvel movies at the start of March, and after watching Avengers Endgame I literally cried because I now understand it so much more than I did a year ago when it came out, because now I understand every single reference they made. Because before I only watched like a couple movies in advance, but now I understand it and I understand why they hate Thanos so much. Then like, I don't know, just watch it. This is the movie I've most recently watched, which is on this list, and I watched this like 2 months ago in September. The movie is called The Big Short. Don't know why I didn't mention it, but that's the name. It's got Steve Carell in it. Love Steve Carell. And it's got the other guy in it. Oh my god, what is his name? Ryan Reynolds? No, what's the other one? There's Ryan Reynolds and there's like another actor who like gives me the same vibe. I'll just look this up quickly because I feel like they look alike, or I get them mixed up. Ryan Gosling. That's why they have the same first name. Oh, it's got,
what is his name?
Oh, Christian Bale. I don't know who, like, I've heard of him, but never really seen anything in his. I'm so bad with actors' names. Like 3 weeks ago I watched the whole of the Batman trilogy. He is fucking Batman. I watched his face for 7 hours and I didn't know what he looked like. Oh, Brad Pitt, that's the guy. It's got a killer cast. It's in like a fake documentary type thing about when the whole economic recession with all the housing crisis at the end of the 2000s. If you don't know me, I'm not good with economics. I don't understand quite a lot in this movie. I mean, it taught me about bonds and like investments, and it's about how these people, and it's based on a true story. That's the cool part. These people like predicted the whole economic crisis. Everyone's saying that like they're crazy, but you know, because we're in the future, that they were right all along. So it's kind of them trying to make the most money out of this whole event. How they describe all the boring economic stuff, they do it very simply, which even a 16-year-old like me can understand. The next movie I'll be talking about is the whole The Hangover franchise. This movie is not talked enough about how great of a comedy this is. One of my favorite movies. I love the 3 movies, The Hangover. I watched them when I was quite young. I love Zach, what's his last name? Galifianakis. Bradley Cooper's in it. Ken Jeong, who plays Mr. Chow. And he is like one of my favorite comedy actors. He is so talented at being funny. And he's also in Community. And he's like probably one of my favorite characters in Community as well.
He's just so funny.
It just overall comes together to make a very good comedy, which you should watch if you have not seen it. It's about like these people who get like blacked out drunk and they can't remember the whole night before, and then they lose their friend. It's all about them like trying to find their friend, but remembering bit by bit what happened. And the 8th movie I will be talking about is Harry Potter. I'm British. I grew up on these movies, but I never really liked them that much. But over the years, I started to watch them in and out a bit. But then in January, I watched them all in order. And now I can say that I love them. They are just the vibiest movie ever. Christmas at Hogwarts. I will pay good money to experience Christmas at Hogwarts. Even though the author of the books We don't know her. She's gone. I'm separating it for the sake of it, but she is not it. I don't even want to say her name because she doesn't deserve to be spoken about separately. The movies are really good. I've never read the books. I don't want to read the books. Everyone always says you should read the books, but I don't want to. I just want to watch it because I'm too lazy to read and it looks really long. It's very nostalgic for me and it touches my soul. The last movie I'll be talking about before I literally lose my crap because I'm so tired and... But I want to start editing this video. Oh god, I just messed up my hair. The last movie I will be talking about, which really touched my soul. I love this movie to bits. It's just bone apple teeth. But the movie is Crazy Rich Asians. Love the movie. I watched this in the cinema. And this movie is so good. I love basic storyline, but it's really compelling. I mean, obviously, great representation of Asian people on cinema, which we don't see enough. I'm a firm believer of diversity in movies and TV shows. It's crazy how many TV shows have little diversity in the past. Like, how difficult could it be to cast someone who isn't Caucasian? Friends. Anyway, it was really good. I can't really think about like why I like it. It's just a really good movie. Oh my god, I've literally just forgotten my whole storyline. What actually does happen? I should really like rewatch it. It just makes me feel happy just thinking about it, even though I can't remember what the hell happens in the movie. You should watch it. So those were 9 movies which touched my soul. And hopefully they touch yours in not a weird way, in a consensual way. Please comment what other videos you would want to see about TV shows and movies. Don't forget to subscribe. Let's hit 300 subscribers and have a good day. Follow my Instagram. My Instagram is lovely. It's beautiful. It is everything you want in Instagram. Hint, hint, go follow it. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.